Hello dear students, welcome back to my class. Today we are starting with the topic what is meant by red data book and red list of IUCN. So let's move. Have you heard about the term red data book? Yes, red data book is a public inventory document of the details consisting of the extinction risk of all the threatened organisms, that is threatened animals and plants, which is present all over the world. This book was first published by the Special Survival Commission of the IUCN in 1966. Later, the book was published from the Switzerland by the same IUCN, that is International Union for the Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. What this red data book includes? It encompasses the comprehensive narration or description about the threatened species. And what are the different kinds of description it includes? It includes the locality, magnitude of the threat they face, ecological requirements they need, they demand, or the concerned species demand, and the conservation strategies that we need to be adopted to reduce or to avoid their extinction. So these are the details which is included mainly in the red data book. Then did you know what actually this book includes? This book generally consisting of two different color pages. That is a pink colored pages and a green colored pages. The pink colored pages consisting of list of critically endangered species which are at the verge of extinction in the future, while the green pages consisting of the species which are already endangered. It was formerly endangered, but now at the they are being recovered. So they are included in green pages. So that's all about the red data book. Okay. Then have you heard about this? What is mean by the red list of IUCN? Yes, in this red data book, you can see that some species are, most of the species are categorized in different kinds of groups based upon certain criteria. That means organisms are grouped under mainly 9 categories based upon their current population size, their pace of dwindling or declining, or their range of distribution, then their fragmentation as well as segregation in the habitat, in the ecosystem itself. So based upon this criteria, we are classifying organism into 9 different categories. What are they? The first one is called extinct species, which is represented by EX. What does it mean by extinct species? Yes, we know that the species whose members have become long extinct, that means they are extinct for a long time and they are not represented by any organism in the earth itself, is known as extinct species. Okay, for example, dinosaurs. Dinosaurs are extinct species. Then species which are extinct in the wild, which is represented by EW. What is mean by this? These are the living representatives which are altogether absent in the natural habitat but are present in the captivity in zoos, arboreta, domestication, cultivation, etc. Or they are living in small areas well outside their natural range, which means those species which are generally present, once present in their natural habitat, are generally, we cannot see them in now. Okay, but we can observe and we can see them only in certain captivity centers like zoos, arboreta, wild and domesticated areas or cultivation, etc. Only in this area we can see these kinds of organisms. Or they are living in small areas well outside the natural habitat. This is known as what? Species which is extinct in the wild. We can say that some species which are not seen in the natural habitat are seen in zoos, in the case of animals, and about in certain endangered plants you can see in certain arboreta. Okay, so that is called a EW, or species which is extinct in the wild. Then comes critically endangered species, that is CR. It is represented by red color, right? Here the members which are at the highest risk of immediate extinction in the wild. which means those members which is generally found this natural habitat becomes immediately extinct in the wild. Okay, that is called a critically endangered species. Then comes endangered species or EN. Okay, here these are also some like critically endangered species. Here the members are also at the highest risk of extinction in the wild in the near future. In the case of critically endangered species, they will be extinct. Immediate extinction will take place. But here in the near future, these members becomes extinct. That is known as endangered species. Okay, then comes vulnerable species, vulnerable, VU. Here the members which are highly endangered, somewhat similar to critically endangered and endangered species, but here in a moderately distant future they will become extinct. That is known as vulnerable species. Then comes near threatened species. Near threatened species means NT. Okay, the members are likely to become endangered in the near. In the near, they will become endangered. Okay, that is known as near threatened species. Then least concerned species. Least concerned here. Least concerned species, it is not much more danger than all these things. Okay, it is represented by a green color. Here, the members are at the lowest risk of endangerment and they enjoy a wide and dense distribution. That means those members which is coming under this particular category, LC, we can see in almost all habitat. It means they are having a dense distribution or cosmopolitan distribution, but they may be getting extinct not in the near future. Okay, so that is called a least concerned species. Then data deficient species represented by DD. Here the enough data are not available to assess the risk of endangerment or extinction. We cannot say that the species is at the risk of extinction or endangerment because we didn't have enough data. Then not evaluated species, that is NE. Here the risk of endangerment has not been evaluated. Okay, no evaluation has been done into this particular species on the basis of extinction. That is called NE. Okay, so these are the 9 different categories of IUCN. I hope you understood. If you have any doubt, please do in the comment section. Thank you.